How an entitled mother, an entitled kid, tried to steal and then destroyed almost $2,000 worth of cards. I judge collectible card game tournaments from local levels all the way up to the local championships. On the local levels, I go from store to store to judge and run events, and the stores would pay me. Really, thanks Magic the Gathering judges, we really owe you for this one. And would let me have extra promos on top of the pay, so I'm usually swimming in promotions. Now, while I'm getting paid to judge, I am not an employee of the stores. In fact, I do this because there's not enough judges in the area, and the stores can't run the tournaments without a certified judge. I am pretty generous with the promos, and give it away liberally as my binder runner over, and I need to create the binder real estate. On more than one occasion, I have snared new players doing this. A few months ago, I was running and judging a tournament at a local store. It was well attended for the store size, as a prize kit that was supposed to have been delivered 2 months before finally reared its head, and this store was the first to get it in the area. So, for a lot of players, this was the first chance for them to get the prizes from this kit. The store also wanted to do the current month's kit at the same time, so the prize payout was going to be amazing for this. The store and I had a system. Players would pay, and right after they paid, I would register them. So I had my laptop behind the counter, next to the register. Again, this was a very well-attended tournament for a local, and ultimately, we have over 40 people registered in a store whose capacity was 50. Here's the deal. At 40-ish people, this is considered to be a small to mid-sized tournament. Tournament entry is usually $20 per person. On top of that, the players buy a lot of product, as this is the only time they usually get to this store. Everything from sleeves, booster packs, deck boxes, drinks, snacks, other games, etc. On a tournament this size, the store can easily make 50% of their profit for the month. It took us about 45 minutes to get through everyone. I got some good nature ribbing for something that happened at a regional event. The players are awesome. They come from all walks of life, from high school kids to career veterans to business owners. They're a community, lend each other cards, buy drinks and snacks for each other. They helped me out when I first got started in the game and helped me through some really hard times in my life. They are my nerds and I'm their geek, and I love them. So, as I registered people, I was giving them the participation prize, and when I finally got the last person registered, I immediately paired the round and was about to welcome the players and do general announcements. Enter Entitled Kid. I've seen Entitled Kid before when I came here for other game nights, when I'm not judging, and he was just obnoxious. He would lose and slam down his card. He would make rude comments, and overall, win or lose, going up against him was an NPE, negative play experience, and has been warned to fix his behavior a few times. But it never improved, and I finally had to recommend to the owner to ban him from the store, just as I was getting ready to do my thing. He comes up to me and says, "How come I didn't get one?" "Oh, I'm sorry, what's your name?" "I'm Entitled Kid." "Oh, I'm sorry, I don't see you registered for the tournament. You're gonna have to pay first, then come back here." The kid huffed and went away. I figure if he doesn't come back in 5 minutes, no big loss, and I'll start the tournament. I took the time to pull the rest of the prizes out and get them sorted so it'll be easier when I need to give them out. Just as I was about to start again, I see Entitled Kid comes into the store with Entitled Mother in her full Karengalia, and they are making their way towards me. She puts her coffee on the counter.
"Explain to me why you didn't give my son a card."
"I'll give him a card, but he has to pay his entry for the tournament so I can register him."
"He said you give away cards to people before, so why can't you do that now?"
"Huh." At this moment, I have a flashback of something a sister said when out to eat a few weeks back. "Your generosity is going to bite you on your ass one day." And in this deluded flashback, my sister is cackling maniacally like an evil witch putting a curse on me.
"Oh, that, well, that's my personal collection, and I hand out extras that I have."
"Well, can Entitled Kid have one of those?"
I'm thinking I got to get this tournament started, as players were getting a bit antsy. I guess, but isn't Entitled Kid going to be playing in the tournament?
No. Why would he be playing in the tournament with these losers? Besides, I have plans and need to get going soon.
Okay, well, let me get this tournament started, and I'll go to my car to get my extra binders.
This is ridiculous. Why can't you just give Entitled Kid one of those cards now?
Well, those are for tournament participants, and since Entitled Kid has neither paid or will be registering for the tournament, I can't give him one. It wouldn't be fair to everyone else in the tournament.
I don't care about that. Entitled Kid wants one of those, and you will give him one, asshole. Where is your manager?
Oh my god. Realizing that I'm having a hybrid r/entitled parent and r/I-don't-work-here-lady moment, and deciding I wanted neither, I say, you know what? I have a tournament to start. So I start walking towards the tournament area, and she reaches over the counter and grabs my shirt, jerking me back. I almost fell on my ass. When I recovered, I told an actual store employee to go get the owner.
Don't walk away from me!
I notice a few players getting up trying to get my attention, and I give them a 1 sec signal, and then notice the player was actually pointing at something. I look in the general directions of where they're pointing, and I see Entitled Kid going through the top cut prizings and putting cards in his pocket.
Entitled Kid, stop! Those aren't yours, you didn't earn those! Shut up, aren't you in enough trouble? Don't talk to my kid that way, I want your manager now!
At this point, the prizes was in disarray, and Entitled Kid had pocketed a lot of them, and I'm still in Entitled Mother's grip. I twisted my body to free myself from Entitled Mother's grip, and then she slammed her hand on the counter and was about to go off again. When we noticed the force of the slam has tipped her coffee cup over and spilled the coffee all over the prizes, and it also splashed onto cards that a guy was selling. The owner walks in just as all of this was happening, and he had a look of, I have had enough of this crap! Players immediately rushed us, surrounded Entitled Mother and Entitled Kid, and switched from going off on them and trying to explain to the owner what happened. The owner was ex-Navy, and in a voice that only a retired sailor could muster, told everyone to shut up. When everyone was quiet, Entitled Mother thought she won, grabbed Entitled Kid, and with a look of triumph on her face, said to Entitled Kid,
Did you get everything you wanted? Yeah. Fine, we're leaving. Oh, and you should fire this guy.
You're not going anywhere. Clerk, all the cops.
What? Well, good, I needed to tell them how your employee assaulted me.
He's not my employee, and he didn't assault you.
He points to the cameras he has all over the store, and Entitled Mother, oblivious to what he's implying, just went on.
Yes, he did. He also denied Entitled Kid what he was owed, and tried to steal cards from him. I demand you fire him, or we'll never come here again.
The owner, completely fed up, and in his salty sea dog voice,
Good! Never come here again! Make my year! I would love to never see you, or see your spoiled brat, cheating sore loser of a son here ever again. This guy is not my employee, but he's more valuable to me than that measly $5 Entitled Kid pays for a single booster pack every week.
He kept going, and throughout all this, I'm trying to clean the promos. But as I got through, it was just more and more evident that there was nothing we can do to salvage any of it. My heart broke. Not for the monetary value of over $1,000, but because the players that was looking forward for months on this chance to get the prizes, and now these things are worthless, and wouldn't even be usable in casual play. The owner finished his rant as the cops arrived, and Entitled Mother rushed them, and tried the same thing about me assaulting her, and trying to steal the cards from her kid. The owner looked at the cops, who he apparently knew from somewhere. Owner,
Cop 1, that's not true. Come on back and I'll show you the video.
Cop 1 went back with the owner, and Cop 2 was talking to the mum. A player noticed that there was blood on my shirt, and goes, Dude, are you okay?
Yeah, I mean, not really.
Look at all this. I can't give this to you now.
Oh, no, dude, you're bleeding.
What? I look where Entitled Mother grabbed me, and there are bloody lines on my chest. I guess she grabbed me and her nails broke skin.
One of the players was an EMT and grabbed the first aid kit and started tending to my wound. He said it didn't look too bad, but Cop 2 asked what happened and the EMT what happened. EMT told him everything that happened. Cop 2 put entitled mother in cuffs. She was cursing up a storm and tried to run away, but the sea of nerds that are my amazing players blocked her. A few minutes later, Cop 1 came back and wanted to talk to me and the dude that was selling his cards. They asked us if we also wanted to press charges, as the owner is pressing charges. The other guy said yes, apparently her coffee destroyed about $800 worth of cards that he was selling. I'm thinking about the disappointment my players must be feeling, and I got really angry, and I decided, yes, I wanted to press charges on her. In the end, she was arrested and was charged with theft, which is what the entitled kid had pocketed, destruction of property, the prizes, the cards the guy was selling, as well as assault and battery, grabbing my shirt and scratching so hard that she drew blood. What stuck with me about that part was that she was about to leave Entitled Kid. Entitled Kid's dad was called and picked him up. I went through the prizes Entitled Kid pocketed and tried to salvage them, but I don't know what he had in his pocket, but these cards were dirty and scratched up. Big shame too, as they were some of the best art I've seen. In the end, the owner told the players he would contact the publisher and see if we can get another kit, and he would refund them their entry as he didn't feel comfortable making these people play for damaged prizes. They players can take what they want. Everyone divided up the prizes as evenly as possible, but a lot of them were just too damaged and warped by the coffee. The players still wanted to play, and the owner told them they can play for store credit, and I finally started the tournament 2 hours late. The first time ever in my judging career, I pride myself on making sure the tournament started either on time or early. I am ex-Navy too, and know that when you're on time, you're late. Entitled Kid was banned from the store, and Entitled Mother was convicted of all counts and was sentenced to probation, community service, and had to pay a pretty hefty fine. There is a really happy ending to this story though. The owner contacted the publisher and explained what happened, and the publisher sent us double of each prize kit that we were supposed to run that day. We rescheduled the tournament as soon as we can, and the turnout was awesome, since the publisher sent us so much that almost everyone in participation got a prize. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed that story. Tell me what you thought of that big one down in the comments down below. Hopefully I'll have half an hour episodes back to you daily at this point. I'm just settling down for a new place that I'm moving into, so I'm not completely set up yet, but it's not going to be too much longer. Anyway guys, I hope you're all having a good day. I'll talk to you guys in a little bit, and I'll see you later. Bye!